We're talking COVID now. One of the more unusual symptoms of COVID-19 is a loss of taste or smell. That's been Charlie Webby's reality for more than 2 years. Think about that for a minute. How much enjoyment losing your taste and smell would strip from your life? Charlie is here to share this experience with us, and we're so grateful for it. Morena, Charlie, how are you doing?
Morena, I'm good, thank you. I'm good.
You know what, I was just enjoying a nice cup of tea this morning and just before and thinking how awful it would be not to enjoy something as simple as a cup of tea.
Oh, do you know what, I still put tea bags in my tea even though I can't taste it because it's a bit sad just having hot water and milk, so I still have tea.
Oh,
it's just
Charlie.
A bit different.
Yeah, okay. I want you to take us back to the beginning and tell us about when and how you caught COVID.
Yeah, so it was way back at the beginning. So my husband and I, we were living in England, and we took a trip back in February, I think it was, 2020, to go see family in New Zealand. And we went back via Canada to see my sister-in-law and then back to England. And a few days after we arrived back, my husband got kind of flu-like symptoms, and we joked. We thought, oh, it's not COVID, but better stay at home because people might think it's COVID, you know. So he stayed at home for a week, and I kept going to work for a few days, and then my work shut down. And then it was a good 2 weeks after my husband was ill. I just started feeling a little bit off, and I was unwell for maybe 2 days, and it was very mild, just kind of had some body aches and a little bit of a sniffle. And yeah, I didn't think anything of it, didn't think it was COVID. There were no tests at the time. And then I woke up on a Monday morning and I couldn't taste or smell anything. And I think it took me a few meals to even register that until it hit home. I had COVID.
Wow, and this is at a time when really we didn't know much about it. We didn't know about the long-term effects or even really the short-term effects, did we?
No, and smell and taste wasn't even a recognised symptom at the time, so it was all a bizarre experience. It still is a bizarre experience,
yeah.
But I was kind of one of the first to go through that and have it recognised as a symptom.
That's incredible, Charlie. Talk us through that just quickly, that initial period of first contracting COVID. Was it rough for you, or were you okay in the first instance?
No, I was fine. It was really, really mild for me. I kind of thought that I'd maybe just worked out a bit hard the day before and that's why my body hurt. It didn't even register that I had COVID until, you know, a day or two later. And then the whirlwind of, you know, eating and drinking anything I could get my hands on to see if I could taste anything, and of course I couldn't.
Wow. And initially, I guess you just think, okay, well, this might last for a couple of days, much like, you know, if you have a cold, it's hard to kind of taste things sometimes. And then it kept going and going and going. How long into it did you think, okay, this is a serious issue?
Well, I counted it in days at first. Every morning I would wake up in the morning, I'm like, can I smell the coffee? And I couldn't. And so I kind of did it in days. And there were other stories coming out of other people around England who had lost their sense of smell or taste. And I remember really distinctly there was a guy who someone put me in touch with who had also lost his around the same time. And he was like, oh, it took me, you know, 13 days for mine to come back. And I'm like, 13 days? I can't wait that long. And then it kept going days into weeks until I was measuring it in months. And I've just crossed my 2-year mark. So, it feels never ending. And it may be never ending, but fingers crossed, we'll see.
So talk to us about how that presents itself. Are we talking literally nothing? No smell at all, no taste at all?
More or less, yes. So in the first 3 months, I think it was complete and utter in that I couldn't tell the difference between sugar and salt. I could eat a handful of chili flakes and not feel anything. I ate mustard powder. I licked soap. I did some bizarre stuff because it was complete and utter. And then after about 3 months, I could start to distinguish between sweet and salty and a little bit of bitterness and sour sometimes, but no flavour at all. And that's remained, so I can't taste anything. And my smell, every now and again I can smell something, so like once every week, I don't know, maybe one smell will get through, but that comes and goes as well. So at one point I could smell cut grass, but then that fades away again. At one point I could smell one brand of coconut milk, and that lasted for a few weeks, but then that went away again. So smell, every now and again something will get through, but not for the taste, unfortunately.
What is that like to live day to day like that?
It's a bit bland. there's nothing exciting about eating these days. I think I've only really just come to accept it kind of in the past few months that this might be my life now, and I'm more okay with that than what I used to be, because obviously for the first year, every week I was hoping that would come back, because it's something like 95% of people get it back within the first year, and then if you've gone 2 years, it's not likely it's going to come back at all. So I'm a bit more accepting of it now, but for the good wee while it was just really sad to have something that every day, three times a day, would bring me joy, something to look forward to, something to share with friends and family, and you know, it was fun, and now it's not. It's just a thing that I need to do. Yeah.
I think about the mental toll that must take on you.
Yeah, it is. I try not to dwell on that too much. Of course, I have spent, you know, there have been many tears shed, because it is sad, just some of the stuff that I'm missing out on, like what I would do to smell a flower, you know, or like walk down the street and smell the ocean. I live opposite the ocean now in this amazing property, and I can't smell the ocean. Like, I can't go outside and smell the grass. I can't smell the coffee. I can't eat a meal that someone cooks for me. There's this whole element of my life that's been taken away, which I try not to dwell on too much, especially now that we're at the 2 year mark and it's not looking all that great.
What have doctors said to you? Is there anything that can be done here, or is it just a waiting game and hoping that one day you'll get it back?
Yeah, that's about it. I went to a number of GPs and an ear, nose, throat specialist in England. And there are other ways that you can lose your sense of smell and taste, like head injuries and some other viruses. And so there's a lot of study on that. But with COVID, because it's very new, it's a lot of unknowns. So the general answer I got was wait and see, and that it should come back. But not great. And here in New Zealand, I've only been to the GP once because I just moved back recently. And again, there weren't any answers other than wait and see. But there's plenty of internet doctors that have some suggestions, but no legitimate ones so far.
What do you miss most, Charlie? If you could eat one thing and taste one thing right now, what would it be?
Oh, that's such a cruel question.
I'm sorry.
Do you know, so sad. I miss mango, I miss chocolate, I miss the bad things, I miss cake and, you know, all the sweet and bad. I miss cheese. It's the unhealthy things I probably miss the most,
I'm so sorry that I asked you such a cruel question to finish off our interview.
Oh, no, it's okay.
Charlie, thank you, though.
Thank you for me.
Yeah, I'll go and enjoy it. Charlie, we really appreciate your time this morning, and thank you so much for sharing your story. And genuinely, from all of us here in the studio, we're thinking of you, and we so hope that one day in the not too distant future, you'll just wake up and you'll be able to smell the coffee.
Literally smell the coffee, yeah, fingers crossed, eh?
Hey, thank you so much. That's Charlie Webby joining us from Homoana in Hawke's Bay this morning.